Once again on Hockey at Home, we're bringing some of the NHL's greatest players face-to-face with their biggest fans.
Luna the dog repping the Sabres jersey.
That background's pretty great.
Let's see what these super fans have in store for all of their favorite players.
I'm ready to rock.
Hey, everybody. Welcome into an all-new episode of Hockey at Home. I'm Catherine Tappan, joined by my good friend David Amber. And once again, we are going to bring you a unique opportunity for the fans in this episode, as they will get a chance to virtually meet and greet their favorite NHL star and even ask them a question.
That's right, Catherine. Last week was so much fun. So today it's round two, NHL superstars meeting their super fans. And we have two great NHL players rolling your way. In a matter of moments, I'll be speaking with Matt Duchene. But first, it's Kat with our first guest today, Hockey at Home.
And joining us now is the captain of the Buffalo Sabres, Jack Eichel. Jack, good to see you. How's everything going?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing okay. How have you been managing your time during this time off?
I think probably pretty similar to everyone else, just trying to stay busy, working out if I can, and watching TV, playing video games, doing a little reading, nothing too crazy, but it seems like it's been a while since, life was normal, but, it seems like people have been adapting pretty well, so it's been good.
Well, we're going to give you the opportunity to make some fans' days today, because we've got some super fans that are dying to meet you and dying to ask you some questions. You ready?
I'm ready to rock, yeah.
Awesome. Okay, we're going to start with John Ballen, and he's joined by his sons, Matthew and Zachary. They join us from Elmira, New York. Hi, guys.
Hi, Jack.
Hi.
Hey, what's up? How are you guys doing?
Good.
Awesome. Good to see you guys. Do you guys have a question for Jack today?
Yeah. We're wondering, what are some of your favorite things to do when you're not playing hockey?
Some of my favorite things to do when I'm not playing hockey. Well, during the season, I do a lot of sleeping when I'm not at the rink working. definitely try and use the downtime to catch up on sleep. But other than that, obviously, pretty normal. Just like to relax, and I'm a big fan of golf and going to the beach. Just trying to find ways to get your mind off hockey. So pretty normal stuff, I think. Nothing too crazy. I'm a pretty big music guy, so I like listening to a lot of music as well. So that's one of my big hobbies.
Awesome.
Cool.
Thank you. Well, hey, and John, you coach your two boys, right? So I'm sure this has been fun for you guys. Big fans of Jack Eichel's, and I know you guys get to go to games when he's on the ice sometimes in Buffalo.
Absolutely.
So hopefully you'll be back there soon. Thank you guys so much for joining us.
Thanks, Jack.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It was a pleasure to meet you. Hope you guys are doing well.
Thank you.
Thanks. Bye.
All right, let's head to Brockport, New York now. Kate Slow is joined by her brothers, Jake and Jerry. All of them grew up, Jack, in Western New York playing hockey. They are big Jack Eichel fans. They actually wear your number as well.
There they are.
Hello.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
How you guys doing?
Good. How about you?
I'm not bad. Not too bad. Can't complain.
So I've been playing AAA hockey for 2 years now, and I was just wondering, what do you think was the most important thing that you did growing up that got you where you are today that I can maybe do?
Most important thing I did growing up. Honestly, it might sound pretty simple and cliche, but I just loved hockey. My parents, especially my dad, he probably credits that for most of my success. I mean, I literally I ate, slept and breathed hockey. It was, you just got to love the game and devote your life to it.
Well, he definitely does that. And so does my
other son.
They're always playing hockey or talking about it or watching it. So
that's the best way to be.
And you too, Kate, as well. I see you're wearing your Jack jersey there. So, hey, Kate, Jay, and Jerry. Oh, it's yours. Okay. Well done. Well, thanks so much for joining us, you guys. It was fun chatting with you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thanks,
yeah, absolutely. It was great meeting you.
You too.
You too.
Take care.
All right, now we're going to be joined by someone born and raised right in Buffalo. So you can bet he's been watching and listening to Sabres games his entire life. Greg Molfies and his girlfriend Emily joining us now. And hi, guys. You have a special little treat there, too, your puppy Luna.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hi, our Sabres fan as well.
How are you guys doing? Good?
Good.
Good. How are you doing?
Well, I love the puppy and the jerseys in the background.
Yeah, we got the USA Eichel back there. We got Luna the dog repping the Sabres jersey.
I love it.
So I got a question for you. So during quarantine, you get to go out to one place in Buffalo. Where are you going and who are you bringing?
One place. It's a tough one. I mean, there's so many great restaurants, I think, and obviously, you know, love to have a nice meal. But, you know, I don't know. My spot in Buffalo has been Mother's for a little bit, and obviously haven't been able to hang out with any of my my teammates or my buddies in a while. So, you know, if I could grab a night, it'd probably be you know, grabbing a couple beers at Mother's and something to eat with the guys and just being able to catch up and hang out with them for the first time in a while.
It's a good choice. I like it. I've actually been to Mother's myself, so I'm sure you guys have too.
Yep, that's right.
Awesome.
Everyone's right. Been there, yeah.
Greg and Emily, thanks so much for joining us, and for Luna as well. Nice surprise there.
Yeah.
Stay great safe.
Surprise. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you. I like the question.
Great question. We've got more of them coming. You ready, Jack? We've got somebody else on the line here. We got Michael Gerke joining all the way from Utah. Big Sabres fan.
Utah, Sabres fan.
Dad was born and raised in Buffalo. Hey, Michael, how's it going?
Doing good. How about you?
I'm good. I'm good. You're all the way out in Utah?
Yeah.
Born and raised. And you're a Sabres fan.
Yeah, it's my dad. He was born and raised in Buffalo, and my mom's parents were also born in Buffalo.
Oh, nice. I like it. I like it. We got fans all over.
Yeah. So my question for you is, what does it mean to you to be a part of like one of the most elite draft classes in recent years?
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously, you know, a big honor. And I think when you look back at that draft class, so many of the guys have made such an immediate and big impact on our league so far. So it's honestly, it's been pretty awesome just to be a part of that. I think, you know, when we look back in a ways time, it'll, you know, hopefully endure the test of time. And a lot of the guys will still be playing and, you know, it'll be considered one of the, you know, one of the more elite draft classes that we've had in our league and, you know, just honored to be a part of it.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Michael, that was a great question. Thanks so much. Michael started playing hockey when he was 8 years old after, right, learning from his dad. So thanks so much,
Michael. Yep.
Pleasure having awesome. You with us here.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
Stay safe and tell your mother to stay safe, too, working on those front lines.
I will. Yeah, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. Hope you're doing well, and same to your family.
Yeah, thank you very much.
All righty.
That's awesome. All right. Finally, we've got Brian Rye and his son, Quentin from Tolland, Connecticut. Big Sabres fans. There they are. Hi, guys.
Nice. How we doing? What's up, Jack?
I'm doing good. How are you guys up? How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. Staying busy? Yeah, trying to keep busy, stay in shape, you know, keep safe, doing all the good stuff.
There you go.
So our question actually doesn't have much to do with hockey. Earlier on in the interview, you mentioned that you're a big music guy. A couple of years ago, my son showed me on your social media that you were at the Pearl Jam concert in Fenway. Yep. I've been a big Pearl Jam fan. I don't know if you can see behind us, there's a bunch of Pearl Jam posters. And
I like it.
Just wondering what your favorite Pearl Jam song is.
Ooh, that's a loaded question. There's a lot of good ones. My favorite Pearl Jam song. Depends on the mood, honestly. You know what? In our warm-ups at the KeyBank Center, I have the DJ play Once. And that's probably honestly one of my favorites. I really like to get going to that one. You know, I'm also a big fan of Pendulum. You know, it's not one of their most popular ones, but I think it's just a tremendous song. So, you know, I'd probably say those two are probably pretty high on the list for me. I mean, there's so many. You can every Pearl Jam song really you know, really does the trick. What would you say your favorite would be?
I'm a big Yellow Ledbetter fan.
Yeah, yeah, that's, I mean, a tremendous, tremendous song, of course.
Great way to end their shows.
Have you seen them?
Yes, I've somewhere in the area of 50 times or so. Like I've seen, go on.
You got a couple on me. Unfortunately, there's probably not going to be any live shows too soon, but. Yeah, I'd love to go. I'd love to get out and see them again.
Yeah, no, it's we had tickets in Madison Square Garden at the end of March, and we couldn't go because it got canceled. So, you know, hopefully one day we'll be back watching hockey live and getting to go see stadium shows.
you guys will have to convert Eddie Vedder from his Hawks stardom and his Hawks allegiance to Sabres fans like you guys.
That's tough. Yeah, yeah. That'll be tough.
He has the Seattle team to deal with now. He might
have to. Yeah, there you go.
Brian, Quentin, thanks so much for taking the time and joining us and for converting over to Sabres fans. I know, Brian, you were a longtime Whalers fan before they moved. So wise choice with Buffalo, as Jack would agree.
Absolutely. Yeah. I appreciate your support, and I love the question. That's one of my favorite topics to talk about.
Great. Thanks. Thanks to everybody, and thanks to you guys for having us on.
Absolutely. Yeah, stay safe. All the best to you and your family.
You too. Stay safe, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Jack, I know you'd agree with me. Sabres fans are some of the most passionate fans in the NHL, and they gave you some good questions there. That was fun.
Yeah, they had some great questions. It's always a lot of fun interacting with the fans, and the Buffalo fans are so passionate about the team. So it's great to see them doing well.
It's great to see you doing well as well, Jack. We look forward to seeing you on the ice sometime down the road. In the meantime, stay safe, and thanks so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me. It was a lot of fun, and hopefully you're doing well, and hopefully we're back on the ice soon.
Great stuff with Jack Eichel there. And up next, we head to Nashville. Matt Duchene joining us on Hockey at Home.
Now Forsberg turning. Here's Duchene, he scores! Matt Duchene's first goal in a gold jersey.
Pleased to welcome in Hockey at Home, Matt Duchene. You've seen him win Olympic gold, World Championship gold, World Cup of Hockey gold. And he's wearing the gold of the Nashville Predators right now. Great to have you along, Matt. How are you holding up during the pause?
Yeah, it's been obviously it's been challenging. It sucks to not be playing hockey and finishing the year, but it's been great to spend some time at home with my son and watch him grow. You know, I'm never going to get time like this with him again. So just taking it day by day right now.
All right. Well, that's great to hear. The fun part of this show here is we're allowing the fans to get up close and personal from a distance with their NHL heroes. And let's welcome in our first guest. We have Thomas Robinson and his son, Max. These guys have been diehard fans, literally, since Max was a toddler. And here he is now, 15 years of age. So Thomas Robinson and his son, Max, welcome to the show.
What's up, guys?
Hey, Matt. Welcome to Nashville.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, guys. You're like your man cave you got going there.
Appreciate it. We're big Preds fans, and we're looking forward to you getting back on the ice sooner than later.
I hope we're back at Bridgestone and playing in front of you guys soon here.
We were actually at the last Predators home game before the stoppage, so that was pretty fun.
Yeah, that was a good one. That was a great one for sure.
Big win against Dallas. It was a great last game before the stoppage. Yeah.
So, Matt, what are you doing during the season stoppage to keep yourself in shape? And when the season does eventually start back up, do you think the Predators will be real contenders?
Yeah, I mean, to answer your first question, I've been working out in my driveway and in my garage quite a bit. Our strength coach at the team gave us a program that I've been following right now. I'm probably going to transition into my summer stuff here in the next little bit. I just got some, I don't know if you guys know what Mars blades are, but they're like a roller blade that kind of mimics a skate. I just got some put on a pair of skates, and I'm going to start working a little bit on those. And so that's what I've been doing. And then, I think it's been a trying year for us a little bit up and down, but we put ourselves in a playoff spot right now. And I think we'll be more in sync when we get back for sure.
That's great. Hey, that's great news. Thomas and Max Robinson, I'm sure you'll be back at Bridgestone before too long. Thanks for joining us here. A lot of really diehard Predators fans, they want to roll in here, including Brittany Wiesman. Again, a 10-year season ticket holder joins us now, Hockey at Home, again from Nashville. And there she is. Brittany, welcome to the show and welcome to your one-on-one with Matt Duchene. What do you have for Matt?
Thank you. I'm actually just wondering, I know that you've done a lot of good since getting here, but since you started Duchene's Honky Tonk, have you had a like extra special memory or favorite experience that you've had since starting that?
Oh, well, thank you, first of all, and nice to meet you. Thanks for jumping on, and thanks for your support. Obviously, it's my first year, but 10-year season ticket holder is pretty special, so I really appreciate that. It's been a really special thing for me to start that, and I don't know if there's one specific thing that sticks out to me other than the fact that I'm so grateful to our local country artists that have supported this cause and have come out and gone into my suite. Some of the names we've had have been incredible. Guys that I knew already and are friends with, and then some some guys that, you know, stopped in. I know Luke Bryan stopped in one game, which was pretty cool to see. And just to see the smiles on kids' faces and coming out to a game and win or lose, I mean, it puts things in perspective for you after. I'd say that, you know, I've gotten as much out of it probably as everyone else in the program. So it's been amazing along with the Predators to be able to set that up. And I'm looking forward to many more years of it.
That's incredible. It's been really neat to see it just kind of grow and take on a life of its own.
I appreciate it. Thank you. It's you definitely don't do it for anything other than to give people a great experience. And we've raised a lot of money also auctioning it off. And at some point I'll be able to donate that money towards a really good cause. So I'm excited for that for sure.
That was a great acknowledgement and question, Brittany, because there's the whole charitable arm of things as well. You don't always remember that they do those things in the community as well. And you've been a big part of Predator community for the last decade as well. So thanks so much for your time here, Hockey at Home with Brittany. She mentioned the kids, the smiles on their faces, Matt. And we've got the next generation of Preds fans. They're already pretty excited about the team and about you. Kai and Ava Davis, the twins, welcome to the show now, because they're some of the younger Predator fans. Look at them. You're going to be looking at this soon.
What's up, guys? How you doing?
Good.
Yeah? You guys doing well over there? I know it's tough right now not to be able to do normal stuff, but you guys doing all right?
Yeah, yeah. Doing good.
Awesome. You guys look great in your gold.
What's your question, guys, for Matt?
And what do you miss most about playing hockey?
Oh, man. Do you have enough time for me to list all this stuff? Or, you know, I miss playing at home for sure. I mean, our rink is so amazing and you guys as fans are incredible. That's something I miss a lot. I just miss the rush of playing and the competition, being with your teammates, that kind of thing. I think this whole stoppage and even us potentially coming back and playing in front of no fans has made me just stop and be so grateful for what we get to do every day. So I feel very blessed, and I know at some point it'll come back and it's going to feel better than ever.
And guys, real quick, who's your favorite player on the Predators?
Magician!
Good answer. I thought that might be the answer. That's awesome, guys. Kyan, Ava Davis. Oh, look at that. That is awesome. Listen, you got old fans, young fans, new fans. It's great to see so many fans of the Predators. And keep it locked here. Hockey at Home up next. A lot more with Matt Duchene and the Predators fans.
Cross Duchene, and he scores! The first shot on goal for the Predators becomes a goal.
Welcome back, Hockey at Home. Matt Duchene of the Nashville Predators. Once again, we're welcoming in fans to say hi to their hero and the team they love, including all the way from London, Ontario, Leah Regan, who's made the car trip many times, Matt, to come down to see you and the Predators. An unbelievable fan, and there she is. She's got the nice Smash hat on as well. Leah, welcome to Hockey at Home, and there's Matt Duchene.
How are you? Hey, Matt.
What's going
on? How are you?
I'm good.
So I know you're a big country music fan. And you had the opportunity to perform with Lee Brice at the 2016 NHL All-Star Weekend in Nashville. So I just want to know how nervous you were for your big country music debut.
Well, believe it or not, that wasn't my debut. I've actually done that with Jake Owen and Thomas Rhett. And I also soundchecked with Garth Brooks and his band before. So that was kind of my fourth or fifth time doing that, believe it or not. So. No, that was, but still very cool. That was probably the most I've ever got to kind of play guitar. I didn't have to sing, so I wasn't quite as, nervous as where, when I was with Jake and TR, when, they handed me the mic for a full verse. So, definitely a really cool moment. And, that weekend was one of the coolest weekends I've ever been a part of.
Yeah, it was a pretty awesome weekend.
Thanks for popping on.
Not a problem. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, that's great. Care.
I mean, you see how devoted these fans are. I mean, a 10-hour drive all the way from London, Ontario, down to Nashville to participate, to get a chance to see you and the other Predators players. That's pretty cool. We welcome in one last fan to say hi, hello to Matt Duchene. And that's, he goes by Shaq.
Okay.
Keith Shackelford. And let's see. Oh, what's that in the background?
That's awesome. That's... So my young lad just woke up, so sorry if you can hear him in the background. Yeah, that background's pretty great. Ironic, eh?
And Keith, I know you're a big diehard fan. You're poking fun about that goal back in 2013, but yeah, what do you have for Matt?
Well, I only have one question, but it's in four parts.
Okay.
So parts one and two, if you were to go out on tour with an artist or a band, give me one act that is no longer touring, such as the Beatles or our favorite NSYNC, and one act that still currently tours. And then part three and four, what instrument or would you sing? I think you've already answered that you would probably play guitar. Oh. But if you weren't on stage, what would you do in the crew?
Ooh, those are good questions. So band that's not touring anymore, probably, I mean, he's passed, obviously. So Johnny Cash, I mean, the show he would have put on would have been incredible. And then you asked me present. What was the other part of it? Present tour. Anything Eric Church, he's my favorite. Those two guys for sure. And then, yeah, I want to play guitar in some way. If I'm not singing or kind of playing rhythm or whatever, I'd want to, you know, get a little bit better and be like a lead guitarist or something like that. I've always loved guitar. And if I wasn't on stage, ooh, that's a tough one. You know what? I'd love to be the guy that gets the drinks for the band, just bartend the whole night. I think that would be my call.
Bartender in the boom boom tent. I got it.
Exactly. Yeah. Side stage, just handing out red solo cups. Just
most liked guy on tour.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. I win the popularity contest for sure.
Absolutely.
That's a great question, Shaq. And I know you're an exec in the music industry as well. So chances are you're going to cross paths with Matt Duchene down the road in Smashville. So sure, thanks so much for joining us here, Hockey at Home.
Thanks for coming out.
Matt, so you see the fan base. We can hear little Bo in the background. If you have him within arm's length, give him a little TV time if you like.
Yeah. Hey, Bo, come here. Come see. Here, come
here. Can you say hi?
Yeah.
Oh, he's... Bo, there he is.
Just woke up on his nap. Look, say hi.
Say hi. Hey, Bo, how you doing?
David, say what's up.
So we got two questions. Are you going to put a guitar in his hands or are you going to put a hockey stick in his hands? What's going to happen here?
Both. Both. He's, he already loves both. It's the first thing he hands me.
Oh, wow.
Did you say, oh, wow. He looks out the window and does that all day. Every morning we get up, we make a coffee, and he grabs his hockey stick, his Preds, foam stick, hands me one, and then we go and play for a bit. And then he wants me to play guitar for him usually once a day. He'll go and start opening my case and start dancing. So I think he's going to like both.
Well, it's fantastic. Whichever career path he pursues, I'm sure he'll have a lot of fun doing it. So again, Matt Duchene, thanks so much for the time here. Hockey at Home. It's been fun having you interact with your hardcore NHL fans.
Hey, thanks for having me. And stay safe, everybody. And hopefully we'll be back on the ice soon.
Great stuff from Matt Duchene. Kat?
DA, so much fun to hear what the fans want to know of these players during this time. And what a great opportunity for them to get the chance to do that.
My favorite part is the players. Sometimes they get really annoyed when you get a mic up in their face at a media scrum. Nothing but smiles from all the players here. They love to engage with the fans. That's probably something they're really missing at this point, is the fact that they know there's this group of people who are so eager to have the game back. At least they're able to interact here on the show.
Yeah, and I know one thing the players love too is when you ask them questions that don't have to do with hockey, right? I mean, some of the questions were great, like where does Jack Eichel like to go in Buffalo? So it's been fun to listen to the creativity that these fans have, not just hockey related, DA.
Yeah, absolutely. I can show a little bit of the personality of the players, engage with the fans on a different level. It's what we try to bring here, Hockey at Home. And this was a unique idea, something that obviously has resonated quite well with both the fans and the players.
Yeah, we'll have to do more of them, David. But for now, that's it. Another edition of Hockey at Home. Hope you enjoyed it, everyone.